This is 4-H Poultry Judging, Classes A and B, Past Egg Production. First, the students should become familiar with the location of the parts of the chicken that should be examined, including the comb, beak, wattles, shoulder, breast, keel bone, hock, toes, shanks, abdomen, vent, pubic bones, and the tail, all of which are shown here in diagram form. As the hen ages and lays eggs, she packages xanthophyll, a yellow pigment, in the yolk of her eggs. This pigment or color is taken from various parts of her body. In particular, these parts are evaluated for bleaching: the vent, eye ring, ear lobe, beak, bottom of foot, entire shank, hock, and top of toes. First, we'll evaluate a bird with excellent past production. Remove the bird from the cage and look at the eye ring, ear lobe, and beak for bleaching. The comb and wattles should be bright red and glossy. Next, the vent should be examined for bleaching. This bird has no pigment on her vent. The vent of a bird that has good production is bleached, moist, large, and oblong. Next, we evaluate the top of the shanks of the bird. For a good performer, they should also be bleached through the hocks and tops of the toes, and they should be thin and have a groove down the side. The bottom of the shanks and the bottom of the feet should be bleached as they are here. Next, we locate the pubic bones as shown here. Also, gently pinch the abdominal skin to determine how fat she is. Good producers have more fat. By placing fingers between the pubic bones and between the keel bone, bottom of the breastbone, and the pubic bones, you can determine her abdominal capacity. This bird has a pubic spread of 2.5 fingers and a keel to pubic spread of 3.5 fingers. She has had good past production. Next, we check and count the primary feathers on both sides of the bird for signs of molt. The good producer shows all old, worn feathers, indicating that she has not molted. This bird has 10 primary feathers with no signs of molting or new feathers coming in. This means that she has had good production in the past. Next, we look at a bird with poor past production. This bird has a yellow eye ring and a yellow beak, indicating poor bleaching and poor performance. She also has a shriveled comb instead of a bright red, glossy comb, like a good producer would have. Next, we examine her vent, which has a yellow pigment, is small, and more rounded rather than oblong. These are signs of a poor producer. Next, we look at the tops of the shanks and feet. They are thick, yellow, and unbleached, meaning that she is a poor producer. Looking at the backs of the shanks and the bottom of the feet, they are also yellow in color. Next, we locate the pubic bones. Gently pinching the abdomen reveals that this bird is not fat and is a poor producer. This bird has a pubic spread of 1.5 fingers and a keel to pubic spread of 2.5 fingers. She has had poor past production. Finally, we check and count the primary feathers on both sides of the bird for signs of molt. This is a poor producing hen because she is exhibiting signs of molt. There are feathers missing and new feathers growing in, as shown here. As with the first wing, the bird is turned over and the primary feathers are counted. Here again we see evidence of new feathers being formed. This indicates that she is molting or has molted and is a poor producer.